Hi, and welcome to another tutorial of Cork PA Manager 3.1. Today, we will take a look at how to create a new set by mixing and combining two sets. So let's get started with some styles. Click on the New Set button. Select the target keyboard model the set is being created for. In this example, we will make a PA4X set. If you have the latest OS V2 installed, remember to select the OS V2 option and click Apply. Now we need to select and load the set, of which we'll start taking styles from. The set was detected as a PA4X OS V2 set, so let's click Apply and continue. Now let's explore a few things. We can click on this icon here and it would load the bank names if the set contains this information. Beneath each style name, we'll see the style version. Hovering over these red tags, we'll get further information as to when the style was last modified. At the bottom, we have our keyboard set and pad options. On the side, we have a few crucial options, which are pretty self-explanatory. We'll cover them later. So let's copy over a style. We can right-click and copy any style. Come over to our own set, right-click and paste the style. That's all. Now you'll notice that the sound for the keyboard sets have not been imported. That's because we didn't enable this option here. By default, it isn't enabled to save RAM space. Let's enable this option and copy-paste the style again. This time, we've also copied the keyboard set sounds, also known as STS sounds. However, you'll notice Upper Free hasn't been imported. That's because we have the Do Not Import Muted Sounds option enabled. This is a very good option to keep on, so we don't import muted sounds to fill RAM space if we're not using them. We can, of course, unmark it, copy-paste the style again, and that sound would be imported. Please note, pads are not automatically imported. Let's clear this set and start making our own new set. We can copy individual styles. We can also copy a whole page. And even a whole bank. The great thing is, it only takes a couple of seconds to do this. Whereas doing it on the keyboard would have taken a good few hours, if you had the knowledge and patience to do it. Cork PA Manager automatically takes all sounds, multi-samples and samples for you and arranges them accordingly. You don't need to worry about anything. So, assuming we have all the styles that we needed from this set and we wanted to add styles from another set, let's go ahead and load the second set. We either click on the Load Style Set button to load our set, or simply drag and drop the set anywhere in this region. Once the set is loaded, we repeat the same procedure by copy-pasting the styles that we need. Let's take a few. When a sound is imported, it is automatically placed in its original location, if the slot is empty. Otherwise, it is automatically reassigned to a new empty slot, and its original location is remapped and relinked to the style. Cork PA Manager has also been cleverly designed not to import any duplicated sounds, multi-samples or samples to save RAM space. Now, we can also check and see how many megabytes the style is made up of, and which sounds are being used by right-clicking on a style and selecting the Check Sample Size option. Here, we can see details about the number of sounds the set is using and whether the sound already exists in your own set or not. In this case, we have existing sounds. The size of this style makes 14.6 megabytes. However, since we have most of the sounds already, it only requires 1.23 megabytes of RAM space. Now we need to save our set by clicking on the Save As button. Here is a tip. When you're ready to save and if your system is low on resources and low on RAM, Then we can right-click here to clear the set from memory. This would clear RAM and not cause bottlenecks when saving the set. Remember, this is optional. Let's rename our set and save. Now that our set has been saved, we exit the Style Manager. Our set has now been saved to our desktop and contains only styles. Now we need to add our performances, also known as keyboard sets. Now remember, we need to be using the set we just saved from the Style Manager. We can either click on the Performances button and load our set, or we can simply drag and drop our set. Once loaded, we choose the PA4X model and continue. We load the set of which we'll be taking keyboard sets from. The rest is exactly the same as we did with the styles. We start copy-pasting the items we want. You'll notice muted sounds are not imported by default. This again is to save on RAM space, which we can of course bypass with the option on the side. Let's load our other set and take some more performances, so that we can integrate them to our own set. Let's start copying some performances onto our main set. Once you've taken all the performances you wanted, it's time to save the set again. Remember that every time a set has to be saved, it needs to be saved as a new set. You should never overwrite over an existing set as it may cause conflictions with the PCM samples. Plus, it's always good to have a backup of your original set. Okay, we now have our styles and performances. It's time to add some pads. Let's load our latest saved set onto the Pad Manager. Again, it's the same workflow. We load the second set, the one we want to take pads from. Once that's loaded, it's time to start adding the pads. Please note that unless you add the pads in the original locations, the link between the style and pad won't be broken. However, if you randomly paste the pad, then you will need to relink the style and pad again, either with the Style Manager or on the keyboard. Once all the pads have been imported, it's time to save the set again. Remember, each time we save as a new set. So let's call this My Final Set. And we have our final mix set with our favourite styles, performances and pads. We can get rid of the older sets that we no longer need. All we need to do now is copy our final set onto a USB pen drive and load the set onto our keyboard and enjoy playing. That's all for now. Until next time, goodbye.